project.
So thanks and welcome to my talk about Garrett Code Review and its usage in the Type 03 project. So what can you expect from this talk? The major time I will be talking about Garrett itself, and it's a web-based code review tool, and it's a Git server. And the second part is about Garrett in Type 03, and we have an experience coming from the last 2.5 years there. Just about myself, I am neither affiliated with Google, nor am I a Garrett developer. I have some only four tiny patches getting in there, but I'm not really involved in this project, so we're just the users. I used to be a Type 03 CMS core team member until like a month ago, and when I finally decided to focus more on the infrastructure things. And during my work, I'm a PhD student in communication networks in Würzburg, in the center of Germany. I'm happy to hear from you. Here's my contact, stefan.gebert@type03.org or stgebert on Twitter. Due to the time constraints, we might not have time for questions, but yeah, just come and ask afterwards. The slides are already on SlideShare, and I really added a lot of comments to explain things. So you can go to slideshare.net/StephenKing and download them. So the motivation for code reviews. Why do obviously so many people care for reviewing code? So I have a question. Who writes the perfect code? Only a couple of us. I think the majority, sometimes fails and doesn't know all the best practices of programming. So it's just good to review the work of yourself and of others. Let it be official committers and team members, or let it be just any contributor. So an example policy would be that every change, which is not at least trivial, has to be reviewed by at least 2 other people. And Garrett allows you to enforce such policies, just to mention. So the thing is that you just keep bad code away out of your repository. No, we will fix this later. And that you just learn from others' skills. So how does Garrett code review look like? So you can just use it in your browser. It's a web-based tool that's just the list of open issues here for Garrett itself. And one line here refers to one commit that is currently under review. And you see who's the owner, in which project, in which branch, and you see the voting's positive or negative. And when you zoom into one single change, you see some metadata, for example, the commit message over there, which is just a Git commit message. You can see metadata for which branch, and you can define topics, and also whether it's, you can see if it's under review or it's already merged. And the interesting thing is that you see here all the reviews. You say, you see Martin Fick has voted negatively, and the other guy has voted positive on this one change. Scrolling down a bit leads you to some details. You see here different patch set revisions. So that was the first try. Somebody said, it's not okay, please fix this and that. And the other or somebody else just came here and uploaded a new version. And finally, there's version 3. You see the all the patch set history. And that's the current patch set. Some more details about this change is which files are changed and how much they have been changed. You can directly open a diff view in your browser and really see the changes introduced by this patch. And the nice thing is you just copy that one line into your shell and it will automatically fetch all this changes from Garrett and apply it to your local working tree. So you can directly start testing or building it if you have something that needs to be built. Other than that, you can just add your own review. So you can comment and vote on this particular change. So just to show you the diff view, you can switch between side by side and unified diff. And you see here that for this line, there's a comment that says this type is very wrong, and then Edwin replied, okay, I fixed that, and so on. That's pretty nice and really helps just to improve your code before it gets merged. So to have a short overview, how the workflow of Garrett Review works, it's the author of a patch pushes it to Garrett. This happens through git push, and then you have to apply some arguments, which are always to which remote. Then you want to usually push head and the head pointer, and you want to push to refs 4, and then the target branch, which is master or somebody some released branch already. So this refs 4 is the Garrett magic, which ends up then in the review process when you push to there. So after that, Garrett just create such a new change, so a new line appears in the overview screen, and Garrett notifies the reviewer, so people can subscribe to the project and get an email that somebody uploaded a new change. And then you can have your custom voting categories. So by default, there are two. One is the code review, so you look at the code and say that's good or that's bad, and one is the verified category, where you really test the code. You can also just add additional voting categories. And in the end, you say, okay, that's good or that's bad. And you can give comments or you can just vote. And once there are enough votes collected, you are either able to submit it really into the repository, or you can throw it away, or throw it away totally, which is abandon, or the other or anybody else can just improve that code. And that works by just amending the commit, so reworking it and then just uploading a new version, then and everything starts from the top again. So Garrett is not only a web has not only a web interface, but it's also a nearly full-featured Git server, and it's written in Java based on JGit, which is a Git implementation in Java. It supports smart HTTP and SSH access, not the native Git protocol, but usually you don't need it, or you just replicate your repositories to another Git server. That's pretty common and not very complex. It has a Git web integration as a repository browser, and also there's Gitblit integration, which I tried it some time ago. It did not work so perfectly, but it's nearly finished, I would say. So there are people out there which are using it already. And that's a even nicer and faster repository browser. A very nice thing about Garrett is that it has really, really fine-grained access control permissions. So basically everything you can imagine. You can say these people are allowed to push into that branch with review or without review. Then you can allow merge commits or disallow them, and you can allow tags by some groups or disallow some groups, such things. So just read the docs. There's tons of permissions you can set. So an example which we almost have in our project is that everybody can just come and clone the repository, so get the code just as you are used to it from GitHub or any Git server. And everybody can just, without any login, click through all the changes. So you can go to review.typos3.org and look at our changes. So when I'm a registered user in an organization, I can suggest changes for review, and then some team member has to include it or not. And in the web UI, I can also, in this example permissions, I can also comment and vote on permission, vote on changes. As a team member, I have some enhanced voting. So usually you don't want that two people come here and just put get something successful into your code. So you want usually at least one team member to have a look, and that would be a possibility that you enforce by a +2 vote. And actually, the magic thing is a submit button, which as soon as you have enough positive votes appears, and then one can hit that button and it really gets merged into the repository. As long as you don't have enough positive votes, nobody in the team can really submit that. And also you could say that only team leaders can create branches and tags, and they can also throw away change requests from people that just suggested something which doesn't make sense, and you can say, okay, why should we keep that open? Just throw the change away, and that is an extra permission. So that's a basic, that's the permission setting for a review workflow. When you say, I have some projects which don't want such a complex review workflow, you could just say that every team member is directly allowed to push, so can use Git just as a normal Git, Garrett just as a normal Git server, which is totally fine. Some more things about Garrett. There's a Mylin connector for Eclipse. I just tried it 2 weeks ago. I wasn't able to log in into our Garrett, but it looks pretty neat. You can download all the changes from Garrett directly in Eclipse. You can vote on changes. So if you're using Eclipse for your usual workflow and want to use Garrett, that's, I think, a really goodie for you. The authentication of Garrett. By default, there's no own user management. You always have to connect to something external, which is OpenID, LDAP, or Apache External Auth. So we are basically authentication against our Typos3.org user base, which has some PHP connector. So patches for custom authentication, so to be more flexible, are currently pending in Garrett. I don't know. Probably this year we can expect even more flexibility into this direction. I talked a bit about enforcement of enough positive votes, or the votes which are required to be able to submit a change. There's a prolog rule engine in which you can define also on a per branch basis what, how many reviews, etc. Are needed. And the development, it was Garrett was invented or developed by Google for Android source code review. So that's the reason why it was introduced. And so still the development is led by Google staff, but there are in the meantime also contributors from, committers from from SHP and Sony Mobile, so it's not a Google-only show, so it's really a stabilized development. And Typos3 isn't the only project which is using Garrett. Other open source projects, of course, Android, Garrett itself is using its own dog food. Eclipse switched to Garrett not so long ago. LibreOffice, OpenStack, and also the guys from Wikimedia, which are also here, and I talked to, are using Garrett in a big scale. Commercial, only some examples, of course, all the Android companies and eBay and Red Hat, whatever. So it's not a tiny project that only three people in the world use. But we in Garrett also, I mean, Typos3 also use it. And so just a few words, what's Typos3? Typos3 CMS is the project for which the Typos3 community is mostly known for. It has a pretty long development history, and it's developed since almost 15 years, it's PHP-based. And the community invented also some more new products in the recent years. One is Typos3 Flow. It's a really cool PHP framework. There's a talk, or there was a talk by Robert Lemke yesterday, the chief architect of Flow. And you can probably watch it online in a couple of days. And there's also Typos3 Neos in the making, which is the content management system based on Typos3 Flow. Typos3 is developed. The development is steered through the core teams, which are, depending on the product, between 10 and 25 people. And we use the mailing list for reviews since 2005. And patches were sent via email, and plus one and minus one were collected there. And you had somehow to count how many plus one there were and to which patch set, and should this one still count or not. But there wasn't really some alternative for us, and big changes were a pain in the ass. So compare two patches that were, between them there was something improved. It was nearly impossible, and Garrett makes it totally easy. You can compare different patch set versions in the UI. So you see if the author changed the things you commented on, or if he introduced some other weird stuff. But what I want to say is that reviews are not new for Typos3, so we are pretty used to it. Nevertheless, we replaced all these mailing list reviews with Git and Garrett some time ago. So the Garrett installation at Typo3, I already said, you can just go to review.typo3.org and see the list of open changes there. Typo3 Flow is kind of a bit ahead always. They started in August of 2010, and Typo3 CMS, the major product, is started almost 2 years ago. And in SVN times, we had a bit more than 10,000 commits, and since then, in the last not even 2 years, we had already 4,300 commits via Git. So that really speeds up development because it makes it all the development less complex. Some more statistics I just looked up. Currently, we have 190 projects, and we have like 70,000 changes, and 400 people were commenting on issues, 290 uploaders, and in the meantime, the biggest change with 39 cycles has been merged this way this week. So one change, 39 different patch set versions has been merged. That's the thing which costed probably the most efforts in the history of using Garrett. But it's all the whole cycle of improving the code and making a new patch set is really easy to handle with Garrett. That's a nice tool. Unfortunately, I'm really running out of time. There are hooks available. You can update your issue tracker. You can trigger documentation rendering. You can have Travis connected. If you're interested, there are a couple of comments in the slides. Just go to slideshare.net/Stephen King, and you can see them. And would be nice seeing you as Garrett user. Thanks for your time.